Hi, I'm Chad Wahlquist. I'm an architect at Palantir. Today I have Bennett, who leads a lot of our work on observability, especially in the AI space, which requires kind of new tool sets. So thanks for joining me, Bennett.
Thanks for having me.
So observability and kind of AI, and what does that mean to you? Like, maybe you just give us a little bit of a peek into your world.
Sure. So if I'm building a complex workflow on top of my Ontology and my LLMs, it's going to cut across many different resources that I build on top of my Ontology. And I'm going to want to see tracing and request history and logging across all these different products. And I'm going to want a bird's eye view, and I'm going to want to drill down and see specific executions, specific logs, specific error messages, and drill down to see what is going on in my complex workflows, either if I'm the one triggering them or if an automation or an agent is the one triggering them. Every invocation, every log line, I want to have visibility into what is going on in my complex system.
Yeah. So as we talk about these stochastic agents, it's very hard when agents are calling agents and you're like, what the heck's happening? I think that's really where you're focused in on is really driving that observability into these agentic and human flows all together. And how do I do this in a highly auditable environment? So that's pretty cool. So I know we got a demo today to look at. Do we want to jump right into the demo?
Let's do it.
All right.
Sweet. So here I have an enterprise-grade application, monitoring Onyx Incorporated. And as you can see, there's many different aspects and layers to this application. And so what I first want to do is just peek open behind the scenes and see the complexity of my workflow. You can see the many layers of workshop apps. You can see the many layers of language models being used, AIP logic functions, my Ontology, all powering this application.
Wow.
And it's you want to ask first, like, how can I get into a specific invocation of this workflow and see, like, under the covers, what exactly is going on? And so I can search for a specific function here. I can go to, let's do Titan inventory relocation model. And let me just pop open the run history for this function. I can see, okay, this is being called by an automation. I can go down and see exactly when these invocations are happening. I can see the run times, and then I can go into a specific invocation and see an actual trace for the function invocation. And so here I can see the request being made, specific details in terms of the request status, the result, the arguments being made in this function invocation, my specific interactions with the Ontology that I am using. And then I can hop on over and see any log lines created by either the high trust services orchestrating my workflows or the code that I'm writing within Foundry. I think this is like a great example of things going well. There's also going to be times when my functions are not working as expected. And so here's an example of a Titan Vision image prompt function that is being used to orchestrate some of these workflows, and I'm seeing failures. I can go in to these log details, see the failures happening, click in, investigate, and get like very granular information on, okay, this was a permission denied error interacting with my language models, and get really granular information right to me. And I can action on it, fix this, and build on top of that. And so the vision here is, in this complex workflow, how can I go and search for certain executables, see their run histories, see traces of these executions, and then see logs associated with and kind of dig in to what is going on with my complex system?
Yeah, so you have like a massive complex application, ton of Ontology objects, AI agents running all over the place, like humans calling functions, like all of it. And so now, whether I want to investigate it or I want to, there's a problem or an error, like it's not just how they connect together in the functions, it's like the individual invocations are in here. So like, I think that's the important piece, is to be able to get down to the individual like auditable logs and calls about who did it from where, when did they do it, right? I think that's a huge deal.
Yeah, I totally agree. And you're not always gonna have just one simple function calling the ontology, there could be like a complex chain of an automate calling an action, calling five different functions. And you're going to want to see the kind of cross-cutting nature of this observability and see how it goes through the seams and how Foundry kind of integrates all that for you.
Yeah, and I think that's part of the value chain here is when you're developing and like working on new workflows, or I introduced a new model, how is that actually functioning? So as things are living and breathing over time, being able to actually have a view in at the granular level to understand what's going on, I think is pretty important.
Yep, and from there we can go on over to, let's say I want to investigate my AIP logic functions, and I know they interact with a bunch of different models, and here I can see exactly like the model usage done by these specific AIP logic functions, get the token count and see the cost. And so it's not only showing you the granular logs and the traces, but giving you metrics on top of your workflows to see like where your resources are being spent is also very important here.
Yeah. That's pretty neat, especially when trying to understand the LLM usage across workflows. This is huge.
Let's also dig back into a specific AIP logic function getting triggered by an automation. So we can go into the details, see the trace, see that it's a AIP logic effect executing via automate, get the granular tags on what exactly the monitor, the monitor ID that was triggered, the version, the RID, and then go specifically down into granular spans over the AIP logic function. You can see it was an ontology edit. And so this was writing back into my ontology, and then go all the way down into the model being called, the duration, see the action being executed, and then pop on over and see token usage, see the request being made to my language model, and go deep into this automated system and get granular visibility that you need as a builder.
Yeah, that's pretty cool. That stack trace view is killer to be able to kind of understand the order of operations of these agentic flows. Because sometimes they loop around. I call the model a bunch of times to reason across something, but having the visibility here to be able to understand, the order of execution and what it's calling, and get to that level of like, actually, I want to go see this actual like call. That's pretty cool to be able to debug things here.
I definitely agree. And only getting started in terms of the amount of resources that we'll be emitting into this view and the telemetry getting emitted. And so it's really exciting.
Yeah. And I think that this is one of the things like this type of observability is key to really scale this. It's like, it's nuanced if you do it on one agent here, but let's say you have 70 or 100 agents working across a workflow. Like, how do you debug those things? When it gets big like that, I think that is where this is absolutely crucial to be able to understand what's going on.
100%. And not only are Foundry going to be an AIP going to be emitting a lot of telemetry automatically for you, but there's also a lot of investment in allowing builders to customize the telemetry they are emitting and using open and standard libraries to emit that telemetry. And so that's something I'd love to talk about next.
Yeah, let's take a look at that.
Sweet. So here's an example of a TypeScript v2 function called high priority tickets. And as you can see, I went over into my libraries and I installed the OpenTelemetry API along with the API logs libraries. And these have millions of installs on NPM and used vastly across the developer TypeScript community. And here I can get my tracer and I can start a custom span calling my AIP logic function, which here I'm filtering for open support tickets, which is a very standard type of query if I want to learn more about my enterprise. And then I'm asking my AIP logic function to go and summarize the most important ones and give me like a response as a user, like what are the most important tickets for me to prioritize. And so if we go on over, I have all my run history for my high priority tickets function. I can go into the log details and I can see my custom spans getting emitted. A nice benefit of TSV2 is we auto instrument every outbound network request. So here we can see us interacting with the API gateway instrumented directly for us. And so it's the mix of custom spans from me as a developer, along with the auto instrumentation that AIP provides out of the box, that we're really hoping will encourage builders to have a lot more visibility and trust in their systems.
Yeah, and especially in a heterogeneous kind of enterprise architecture, to be able to have these logs next to the rest of your stuff is pretty useful, or alerting or other things that you're wanting to have. So that's very cool that we can customize all that.
I want to give a massive shout out to the AIP Logic team. They are building very amazing debugger views in their product. And so if we want to take a look at this preview run, we can see in real time traces getting emitted, seeing in real time a debugger. And if I can see the granular real-time steps of my business logic, I just have much more confidence and visibility into these systems. And it's amazing work here. And the broader vision of getting telemetry across AIP and into users' hands as fast and easily as possible is the major focus of the broader group.
Yeah, this is neat. This is probably one of my favorite things to demo, especially a really complex logic function. This one's pretty simple here, but like showing like a very complex chain of thought reasoning in the stack trace happening in real time, being able to debug, understand where the long pole is. It's cool. Like, it's super helpful as you're building these things of trying to debug what model, how am I tweaking the prompt, what's happening. There's so many different variables. So to be able to see it kind of in that view is like really neat.
Yeah, I couldn't agree more. So now taking a look at maybe a more complex workflow, I have a car recommendation automation where I'm receiving a new car and I want to process it. You can see five or six different actions being executed, going into four or five different functions. You can see the user code, the function calls, all the way down to my models. And if we want to see like what's actually being called from these models, we can see like you are an assistant meant to summarize car maintenance reports and predict the likelihood of reoccurrence. And we can see exactly the data that was sent to our LLMs and audit this work. And we can also integrate this with our custom logging, seeing what recommendations we're making for our unique IDs, seeing all the LLM requests, the token usage, the successful executions, going back to our trace view and seeing where the time is being spent, and forward looking, seeing how we can optimize this complex chain of invocations.
Yeah, so like this is, to just kind of take it up a level, like thinking about it as a business process flow, whether it's like order to cash, I get an order in as a manufacturer and I have to figure out, do I have enough inventory? Do I have enough raw materials and production capacity? That entire business process flow, you could actually look at it this way and understand through here the entire flow of how that actual process is happening with logs associated across it and how long it takes, not only at a high level, like we have tools like machinery to look at more of kind of the flow of that, but this is at the actual instance of an object being created, which is pretty wild to think about. Like, oh, I have a trouble order, I want to go diagnose something. You could literally see every single detail about the entire thing in one place.
And on top of that, when I write back to my system and I want to automate further, I get a full history of this whole chain. And I can get insight not from just today, but yesterday and last week, and get a more holistic understanding of the system.
Yeah, because normally like this would be across a ton of different systems. Sometimes you try to throw it in some sort of log aggregator and then query across it. And that's not business friendly, or in like trying to figure out what is this doing, or I'm gonna join a bunch of tables together to try to understand the business process. But here, having all of that lineage tracked as the process is actually happening with the nitty gritty details, like it's pretty neat. All right, that's pretty cool. There's a lot there to be able to like view into the system of systems you're building. So how are our customers using this?
Sure. So one example is Gallatin AI. They build a very complex OSDK third-party application on top of Foundry. And in production, they were able to get visibility into all their complex ontology loading and function calls and action calls, and were able to optimize a lot of their workflows once they had the observability into the system. Instead of needing to kind of guess, they were able to see with real data, real telemetry, where they needed to improve their system. We were able to help them do that. And so that was very exciting. Additionally, a second part of this work is we want to provide an amazing in-platform experience, but we also want to let power builders export their logs to streaming data sets, third-party systems. And so it's been very exciting to see a lot of forward deployed engineers use the streaming data set to build very complex analytical workshops and other monitoring views on top of this data. And that kind of twofold approach has been really exciting.
That's pretty neat. So you're saying I'm emitting my logs to a stream, and I'm able to take that stream and ontologize it and build apps on top of the ontology of the monitoring and alerting of my other apps I built that are maybe consumer facing or customer facing.
Exactly. And so you can also write back to your ontology in terms of a connected enterprise, but then you also want the telemetry of your systems that you're using this back into your ontology. And so it's almost like a second write back to get the feedback loop spinning.
Yeah, that's pretty cool, because I could totally see how then you could even take that a next step further and use AI FDE and start to actually look at the code behind some of these alerts and other things. There could be a whole virtuous loop here now that you have open access to all of the logs. That's pretty cool. So what do you see kind of coming? Like, what are you working on that's maybe a couple months out that would be fun to share?
Yeah, so I would say the first thing I'm most excited about is in-platform metrics and monitoring for these AIP workflows. I have my actions, my functions, my automates. I want to get paged and alerted when things go south, and I want to have confidence that I have a fully monitored system. And I'm really excited for the investments in the metrics and telemetry getting emitted and the integrations with monitoring happening. Additionally, I'm very excited about our push to make the streaming data set an OTel compliant format that power builders can export to third-party systems and use how they like. We want amazing defaults. We want a great in-platform experience, but we also want to be the home of interoperability, and we want power builders to be able to do what they want with their telemetry. And then lastly, I'd say I'm really excited that we have an AIP telemetry kind of data store now across different platforms, products, teams, all emitting to a central place. And now the question is, how do we get it into users' hands as easily as possible across the platform? I have an error. How do I have a one-click way to see my trace, see my logs? And it's really exciting to see all like the developers kind of hone in and come wanting to work on this now that it's finally real, which is really exciting. It's in Workflow Builder. It's going to be more places very soon. And that is what I'm very excited about.
Yeah, that'll be neat to be able to just one click and see kind of everywhere it is, just like we do with data. But now we're talking about the not only the data, the logic and the actions, the ontology objects, all these different components. So I love that we've expanded beyond just the data piece to really get these, you know, the observability across everything. So awesome. Well, thanks, Bennett, for joining me today. I really appreciate the time.
Thanks for having me.